Hi everyone. This is going to be a short video demonstrating how to convert Microsoft Office files to Google Docs, Sheets, and Slides. In a previous tip, you saw that you can upload any file that you might have into your Google Drive and use Drive like a gigantic thumb drive in the cloud. If you have files in Microsoft Office format, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, you can convert those files to Google Docs, Sheets, and Slides formats so that you can take advantage of the sharing and collaboration features. Also, by converting files to Google Docs, Sheets, and Slides, you can use the additional features available within Google Classroom, such as make a copy for each student. You can attack this in a number of different ways. The first way is we will convert one file at a time as we upload it into our drive. So to do this, we need to make sure that our drive settings are set appropriately. So in my drive, if I click on the gear icon here and choose settings, you'll notice that one of the settings here says convert uploads. I want to make sure that this box here is checked so that as I upload Microsoft Office files, Google Drive will automatically convert them into Google Docs, Sheets, and Slides formats. If you uncheck this box, it'll upload those files to your Google Drive, but it will not convert them. So I'm going to check the box and click Done. And what I'm going to do now is basically do what we did in the previous tip, is just upload a file from my computer into my Google Drive, except this time, instead of just uploading it, Google Drive is going to convert it. So I'm going to click on New and choose File Upload. And on my desktop, I have a bunch of files here. I'm going to choose this Easy Chair Microsoft Word document. So I'm going to highlight it and click Open. And you'll see that just like before, it's uploading the file. Except this time, when the file appears in my drive, it's not in Microsoft Word format any longer. The little W icon is not there. It's just it's been converted into Google Docs format. And I can easily check that by double-clicking. And you'll notice that the Microsoft Word icon is not in the upper left corner, and all of the share options are available like they would be for a normal Google Doc. So just by changing the settings for Google Drive and uploading a Microsoft Office file, it'll do the conversion automatically. You may have noticed, though, that there is no original Microsoft Office file in Drive. So when you upload and convert, it does not also place the original file in Google Drive. That stays on your computer. So you may or may not want that behavior. It's up to you. So that's the first way. It's pretty easy to do. And so if you just have a handful of documents to convert, then that's probably all that you need. However, if you have a lot of documents to convert, you have entire folders to convert, as you can imagine, there's an easier way to do this. So just like when you were uploading entire folders to Google Drive, you need to be using Google Chrome in order for this to work. If you're on a PC and you use Firefox, Internet Explorer, or Microsoft Edge, this will not work. If you're on a Mac and you're using Firefox or Safari, this will not work. You need to be using Google Chrome. So I'm going to this time click New, and instead of File Upload, I'm going to click Folder Upload. And I'm going to go and find my folder of stuff. So I'm going to highlight the folder that I want to upload, and I'm going to click OK. And just as before, it's going to upload that entire folder. And the nice thing about when you upload a folder is Google Drive keeps everything in that folder. It creates a new folder with that exact same name, so everything's organized. So once it's done uploading and converting, we'll see a new folder in my Google Drive. Okay, so I can see from this window that the folder is done. It has been uploaded. And if I scroll in my Google Drive, I'll see there's the folder of stuff that was just uploaded. And if I open it up, I'll see all of the files that were uploaded as part of that folder, and they've all been converted into Google Docs, Google Sheets, and Google Slides formats. So these were originally, if I look on my computer in folder of stuff, these were originally a Word document, an Excel spreadsheet, and a PowerPoint file. So by uploading that entire folder, and making sure the settings of my drive were set to automatically convert, it automatically converted all those files at once, which is pretty good. That was pretty efficient in the way that it did it. So the last thing that I wanted to show you is if you already have some Microsoft Office files in your drive. So for example, I have this file called mastersinstructions.doc. It's a Word document, and I can see that it's a Word document by the icon. I don't want to have to re-upload this file to get it to convert. It's already in my drive. So there's another way to convert Office files. It's I wouldn't want to do this for a lot of files because it's a little tedious, but for one file at a time or some files that you already have in your drive, it works pretty well. So I'm going to double-click on that Microsoft Word file that was in my drive, and Chrome is going to try and open that in Office Editing for Doc Sheets and Slides mode, so I can get rid of that window. So you'll notice that when it opens, the icon in the upper left is still showing the Microsoft Word icon. That's because Google's using what they call Office Compatibility Mode to open the file, make it viewable, and you can make some basic edits to it. However, it doesn't have all of the features of Google Docs, all of the different sharing and editing and commenting features. And if I were going to share this document using Google Classroom, I wouldn't have the make a copy for each student option that I do with Google Docs, Google Sheets, and Google Slides. So to convert this document, once I have it open, if I click on the file menu, there's a choice here to save it as Google Docs. So if I click that, you'll see a window showing that it's converting, it's saving it in the Google Docs format, and now it's opened up the newly converted version, and so I can see the icon here in the upper left is no longer Microsoft Word. It's the typical Google Docs icon, and all of the menus and options are what I would expect in a Google Doc. If I go back to my drive, let me delete those, just close those copies, not delete, you'll notice that I have two versions. So it kept the original version because that was already in my drive. So when I opened it and chose to convert it, it didn't delete the original. So now I have the Google Docs version and the Microsoft Word version. So if you want to keep the original versions, you could do it this way, although if I had a lot of Microsoft Office documents that I wanted to upload to my drive and convert, what I would probably do, to be honest with you, is go to Settings and turn off this feature after I do the conversion and re-upload them. So I would have all of the originals in the Microsoft Office format in my drive as well as the ones that were converted. You might want that for archive purposes. You might want that because you don't want to keep anything on your local computer anymore because Drive is just more convenient for you, or you're worried about backups or anything like that. So I hope this tip has been helpful for you. If you have Microsoft Office files and you want to get them and convert them into Google Docs format, Google Sheets format, or Google Slides format, these are the ways that you can do that. Thanks a lot.